So guys, Kevin.
So with the advent of social media, as well as these companies just getting so fucking good at kind of like manipulating the public perspective and the zeitgeist on so many different products, it's a bit harder to pass on items on clothing, garments, shoes, Johns, that I've been struggling with it for the past year or so, like really trying to decide on what is something that I would truly like, rather than, oh, how much exposure has something gotten? Have I seen it enough times? Have I seen enough people or the right people with it enough times? And then it just kind of like becomes like a need. And I think there is something valuable with the skill of learning to appreciate something, but without needing to purchase something. I think that's like such a crucial skill where it's like, you can observe it. You can say, oh wow, that's really cool, but it's not for me. You know, instead of being like, oh, I need this, I need that, I need that, I need that. And then you'll just go into a cycle of like, just continually consuming, kind of contributing to the problem, etc. So I've kind of put together three different tools and tips that I've used in order to decrease how much money I really spend and how much time I spend, as well as how much I genuinely consume. So tip number one, it's fairly easy to do in my opinion. Look at your entire wardrobe and kind of picture the item in your wardrobe and see if it works very well. Most of the times, at least for myself, I try and find something that fits very seamlessly into my wardrobe. Not necessarily having it be like exactly the same as a product that I already have, because then it becomes redundant, but kind of seeing and making sure that it flows well with the rest of your clothes. Because then if you're just gonna have one off item, you're less likely to wear it, it's less wearable, and thus you get less wear out of it, and then it becomes like kind of an empty brick. So instead of falling for, like, I guess the hype and the marketing and the promotion of an item, you would take a second and then really kind of look at it from a perspective of like, can this work with the clothing I already have? Will I wear this enough? Will I get enough wear out of it so I can justify, one, adding another item to my wardrobe, and two, justify the cost of whatever it might be. And yes, there are some key piece items that I think some people have. Like, some people have like highlight items, as well as standout items, like whether that be, you know, some shoes that are really cool, or a parka, or a bomber, or, you know, stuff like that, where that's like the key piece. But you have to still kind of look at it from a perspective of, can I wear this key piece with other clothes that I do have? So I think you can still have the area of like, oh, this is like kind of like a highlight piece, but it'll still kind of flow with the rest of your wardrobe. Tip number two is to bookmark it, save it, favorite it, and kind of put it on the back burner for a little bit. I know this doesn't always work. With a lot of releases, a lot of companies, they try and build up the hype, the momentum, so that people almost impulse purchase on release day, thinking that they're gonna regret missing out. And then most of the times, these companies actually do have back stock of it, so they only release a fraction of it, and then they end up restocking later down on the line. So I think a good way to kind of like gauge that is, like, maybe if you really, really enjoy keeping up with the releases, maybe like take a look at what's releasing in the upcoming like month or 2 months, write down the ones, or jot down like a note of the ones that you personally enjoy or you personally see yourself like potentially purchasing, and then waiting until release day. Sure, this only happens if there have been like leaks or there's information out prior, but I think that's still valuable. A lot of like, especially footwear, that stuff gets leaked like months ahead of time. And then it gives you enough time to really formulate an opinion and then kind of see whether or not this will fit within your wardrobe or not. For Grailed and stuff like that, Grailed in particular, you can put it in your favorites or your wardrobe, and then you can kind of put it on the back burner for, I would say, at least 2 weeks. I tend to do 3 weeks to a month, and then for each week, I tend to comb through it and then go into like my favorites, or on eBay it would be like the watch later stuff, and then I'd remove the stuff that I feel like I just added it just because of the fact that like, oh, I thought it was like a cool item, but realizing it won't fit, in my wardrobe or me realizing, oh, I actually don't really like it enough to purchase it. There are a lot of impulse purchases that happen like really honestly within the day of you finding something. So I think training yourself to like, oh, I like that, I'm gonna save it for later. And then maybe kind of keep it on the back burner and then seeing if you genuinely do enjoy it. And then by the end of what, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, maybe even a month, and let's say it's still there, then I would say go for it. And kind of tip number three is sort of adhering to a budget. So I do think that budgeting kind of does make you a little bit more obviously conservative in terms of money. As well as a little bit more discerning in the types of items that you buy. So I would say like if there's a certain item that you really like but it's out of your price range, put it on your watch list, put it on your closet or your favorites or whatever, and then wait for price drops, a sale or something like that where you can purchase it within your budget. And then that way it kind of rewards you for being patient. So it's kind of like a positive loop, like feedback loop of like, being patient, getting it for cheaper, potentially being able to save money as well as maybe purchase other items for the price of the one item that you would have gotten for that instant gratification. So I think it's that delayed gratification that really helps you build up these healthy habits in purchasing items. So like, I mean, like a John's budget could be anywhere between like, I mean, it really depends on how much you're willing to spend, but like depends on your income. I would say a percentage is usually safe. I guess what I mean by percentage is rather than setting like I am gonna spend $500 on John's every single month and you only make like $1,000, that's 50%. So I would say anywhere between 5 to 20%. I mean 20% is quite generous in like spending every single month. And then as long as you're purchasing items that retain their value, you don't necessarily lose that, so that you can slowly at least accumulate more and more items in your wardrobe, or slowly accumulate more and more valuable items, more and more, I guess I would even say rare items, etc. Kind of putting that into your closet so that you can like build up, and that's sort of how you build up a wardrobe, is that you invest in pieces that retain their value. If you wanted to swap them out, you can sell them and then purchase a different thing and then continually kind of build up that way. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope this helped at all. If you guys have any sort of extra tips, extra kind of methods that you guys have, I'd love to hear them down in the comments down below, as well as other people in the community that would like to hear. Because I do think there's something valuable in kind of learning to be patient and not letting these fucking companies really take advantage of you, as well as your money, as well as like these other people, influencers, etc. So I think it's much better to be more discerning with your purchases. Yeah, so enough blabbering. Thank you guys again. Talk to you guys later. Peace.